Wednesday, of course, here on Rush Talk. My name is Miles Ramiti Apuli, and we are here up to the hour of 10 o'clock. Glad that you're there watching, and it's very important to know as well that you do not only watch, but we appreciate you whatever you are watching this broadcast. And of course, you can join the conversation, join the stories, join everything by downloading the new Vision Digital app. You'll be able to, you know, to catch up on all other programs as well as our socials. Just hit the like button on all our socials. We are live on Facebook on Urban TV Uganda, as well as Twitter. Our Twitter handle is Urban TV. You can actually follow me up as well. My Twitter handle is Urban, is Miles Ramiti. You can, hey, Miles Ramiti, you can follow me up there and of course see what is happening. I hope you're good and enjoying yourself. Wherever you are, just know everything is all right. Even when you know things are not moving well, just assume they will be okay. Be hopeful. You see, if we don't hope, we won't be happy. So, no, Rachel, and Gwanza Wanzan, your figure. We know just one to our nobody data. This is the Rush Talk. We said we'll bring you, you know, people who actually matter, especially in the morning here. And of course, I'm joined by colleagues from the other side, from the Lions Club, joining us here live on the Urban TV. Oh, definitely, we'll take you through and they say hello to us. Then we proceed like that. Good morning, ma'am. I'll start with you.
Good morning to you. Mm-hmm. Good morning, viewers. My name is Lion Honorable Christine Amongnapuru. I'm the district governor for Lions Club.
Oh, Uganda. We have the governor. Good to meet you.
Thank you. Good I'm to happy you, to Honorable. Be here.
Yes.
Yes.
We are glad to see you as well.
Thank you.
Yes.
My pleasure.
Yes.
And
yes.
I've come to recruit you to become a lion.
I'm here. I'm here. No worries. Anytime I'm here. We were here with Dr. a couple of days ago and we were talking about you, this and that, but we're here to hear that. Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Good morning, viewers. I am Lion Dr. James Opiel. I'm a medical doctor. I'm also a member of the Lions Club of Kumi, but specifically, I'm the district chairperson in charge of childhood cancer activities.
Okay.
In the docket of Lion Christine's governorship tenure.
Okay. Thank you. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Doctor.
Yes, please.
Chirichita.
Chitewali mutawana.
Bwana hivyo baliyo.
Yes, tulio.
Bako wachi.
Wazina tabu.
Wazina tabu.
Yes, sir.
You can say all to us as well.
Thank you very much. Thank you much for hosting us. Emmanuel Kisame is my name. I'm the club president of Kampala Victoria Lions Club. And we are the one who's hosting the governor. We, like I told you last time when we came, you were asking me so many questions.
Indeed,
about
many.
Lionism in Uganda, and I promised that I'll deliver the governor to
you. Oh, we thank you. We thank you so much.
Say whatever you want, any question that we want.
We thank you.
Thank you much for hosting us.
Okay. There we are. We will definitely go with the governor now that she's here. First of all, how long have you been in Lions Club, and how did you join it?
I have been in Lions Club from my home district, from my home club, Kumi Central, since 2014.
Wow.
I have been serving as a lion in various capacities, as a secretary, a vice president. Second, I went to the zone where I was leading a couple of clubs. And then I came to the leadership of first vice district governor, second vice district governor.
Mm-hmm.
And now I'm in things as the district governor. 411B Uganda. We belong to a multiple district. A multiple district 411 has Uganda, Kenya, Tanzania, Ethiopia, and Seychelles.
That's the 411.
411
district.
411 multiple district.
Multiple district. It's a combination of all these other countries.
All these other countries.
How come Rwanda is missing?
Rwanda has not yet come to this multiple district, which comprises of these other five countries. Rwanda, they are preparing to enter, to join us, but the aspect of lionism is also in Rwanda, and we are working closely to make sure that since they are part of East Africa, we want to bring them on board as well.
So, Madam President, this is where, what does a country like take to be into the multiple district. What does it take? Because now I understand all these are neighboring districts are part of it, but Rwanda is not yet.
You have to have the numbers of lions. Initially, we used to be with the Tanzania, but because the number of lion members in Uganda came to 1,500 plus, we qualified to separate from Tanzania. And according to our constitution, we now stand as a district, Uganda alone, Tanzania alone. And Kenya is still with Ethiopia and Seychelles.
Okay, there you go. Of course, we are trying to learn things that we do not know also to make you know, us believe we can be part of this whole great organization. What's the main purpose of the Lions Club?
First of all, you should know that Lions is an acronym. Uh-huh. We are not the wild cats in the bush. We are not the wild cats. Mm. We are people. And Lion is an acronym, which means liberty, intelligence, our nation's safety. And I'm happy that today in Aban, the viewers will get to know. Mm. People have been saying, what is a lion? Why a lion? Mm. Eh? That is the name of my clan.
Why not a cow? Why not an elephant? Why not, you know, a tiger?
Because of the kind of service activities we deliver, we decided to say that we must have the liberty to offer activities or services to our people. That's why we chose from our foundation that we should be able to serve the nations so that every nation recognizes the safety and the service that we extend to the less fortunate.
Okay.
And that takes me now to inform you where we came from. Lions Clubs International was started way back.
Yeah, yeah.
Way back in 1917.
Yeah, 1917, yes.
In Illions, in the United States of America.
Illinois, yes, yes.
Uh-huh. Started by a businessman called Melvin Jones.
Melvin Jones, yes.
After the World War, he saw how people were suffering, and he congregated a few business people and said, why don't we start the idea of serving the communities that are less fortunate? That is how we came to existence. And we have been growing and growing. And Melvin Jones at that time started with only 36 delegates. And these delegates were from 22 clubs only.
Okay.
But today we have grown and we have a total of 1.4 million people who are Lions.
1.4?
Yes.
Okay.
So we are growing and we are many. We have a constitution, we have bylaws that we follow, and we have a code of ethics. We are very ethical in this association. So it is a worldwide largest service association. And when we serve, we look at those less privileged people. And we serve in five core areas.
Okay.
Environment, vision, diabetes, childhood cancer, and we have got relief and disaster. So the doctor I have come with, my district officer, is the one who chairs childhood cancer, an aspect that we want to make known to most of the people who are out there. And that is why we are very, very privileged to be here with you.
Governor, I think also from there I'll get back to you. I want, Doctor, particularly from you, I'm curious to know what exactly you, the Lion Club, what exactly you do?
With regard to this particular assignment, a docket I've been assigned is childhood cancer awareness and the promotion of good outcomes of diagnosis and treatment. Childhood cancer is such a heavy burden in this country. And we are talking about figures like between 3,000 and 5,000 new cases per year.
Oh.
And this is a, to say, a conservative estimate, because some experts put it to the level of diagnosis at 10%. Mm. The rest are probably not diagnosed. They just go down the natural history of the disease. So our strategy is to diagnose early, go into the communities through sensitization, through engagement of existing healthcare infrastructure, so that we can pick children who suspect to have cancer early, so that they get diagnosed early and the treatment instituted early, so that the outcomes are good. The earlier that cancer is diagnosed, the better the treatment outcomes. So we're going to do that through sensitization, talk shows like this, like I said, engagement of healthcare infrastructure that we already have, but also through strategic partnerships and engagement of stakeholders.
Okay, interesting, you know, to know some of these facts. And my friend over there, there are things that I still, we need to know, especially as far as Lions Club is concerned. I need to become a member. Someone else, like students would become, want to become members. How do they join?
Yeah, thank you very much. Like I discussed last time, there are so many ways that somebody can join.
Yes.
But one of the strategies of the district governor this year is to recruit as many younger people as possible. And for us in Lions Club,
that's the way forward.
Yeah, we call them Leos.
Oh, they're called Leos?
Yes, they are called Leos, the young guys.
And the women?
And the women are called new voices.
New voices?
New voices, yeah. New voices.
So the Madam Governor here is a new voice?
Yeah, is a new voice. Oh, and okay. When you talk about new voices, she laughs, she becomes very excited.
Because it's interesting. Yes. So it's a new voice.
Yeah,
yes. Okay, new voices. Okay. And basically, then the kids, the young ones are, you say the students are what?
The students are called Leos.
Leos,
the
okay.
Very young ones are called Cubs.
The Cubs, oh, yes. The very young, like primary,
yes.
And all that.
Yes, then secondary, when you go, yes, like, yes. To secondary, university, immediately after qualification, they are called Leos.
Leos, okay.
And one of our strategies is to recruit as many as possible. Actually, she has given us, because she has many clubs in the country, and one of the strategies she has given us is that we have to establish at least one Leo club in every Lions club.
Mm.
Basically, the strategy is to make sure that we include young people so that when the old people go away, there is continuity of Lionism in Uganda.
Yes.
Yes, please.
Uh-huh.
And so, a Leo is not just a Leo.
Mm.
Leadership, opportunity, experience. It's also an acronym.
Yeah.
And we promote young people. And when I was entering here in the studio, somebody said, a lion? Are you a lion or a lioness? A younger man, I met him.
Actually, it is interesting. Are you a lion or a lioness?
Yes.
Why not a lioness, actually? Why new voices?
We used to be called the lionesses. But when the women came into the leadership, because, you know, men, when it started, they were dominating. But 33 years ago, when the women came on table to be leaders, they now said we are all equal, so we are all lions.
Mm.
That is how now the name New Voices came in. And we have our first vice international president, Dr. Pati, who visited Uganda, encouraging us more and more so that we are a new voice, because we are able to make that difference and move together with the gentlemen.
So, Madam Governor, what are the benefits of the Lions Club membership?
Oh, there are quite many benefits.
Yeah, what are some of them?
Some of the benefits I may mention here is that we have an advantage of chartering, recruiting members to join the Lions Club Association. We also encourage peaceful way of livelihood as citizens. As citizens, we should be able to talk to people, we should be able to encourage them. so that we are seen to be people of the world. The other advantage is we work with the civil society. We work with the organizations. We are not just in the air, but we work with the civic leaders, the local governments, to be part and parcel of what they carry out in their various areas or in their various districts. So we want to really say that a benefit is there to serve the less fortunate. And serving the less fortunate voluntarily, serving the less fortunate without any financial attachment, but taking service there, when government does this, we as Lions also offer service. So the benefits are quite many because we nurture young people whom we also inculcate in them the aspect of voluntarism.
Yes.
Because our motto is we serve. That is the motto for Lions Club International.
We serve.
Uganda's motto, yes.
That's international.
International.
Okay.
But the theme this year for us, it is service with friendship. Like now we are here for the rush hour. We are rendering service with friendship with Urban TV. So we need to draw partners as friends. So the benefits are quite many and we encourage work without conflicting. And even in our leadership, we hand over politely, systematically, hierarchically, we hand it over.
So is okay, like I was asking him some time back here, do you have to elect, do you have to to appoint for someone, like for example at your level of being a governor, or you have to go through hierarchy of some sort that you've done this, you have to go at this level? Just clarify on that.
First of all, you should be a member.
By default, you're a member.
From your local club.
Yes.
And from your local club, you will be elected to serve secretary, treasurer, service chairperson, and you have to grow. And our leadership is 1 year, one term.
1 year, one term?
Yes.
So don't we have scenarios where people are serving, like him, I'm sure, where you have to serve a year and then the next year?
But
what are the circumstances that someone have to serve two terms? Even when you know, but the constitution says your constitution should be one term.
We had a scenario of COVID. Our current international past president,
yes,
he had to serve because of COVID. Mm. People were not active. They are exceptionally those times when things are very difficult. Mm. That's when maybe a club decides that you serve two terms. But our constitution, you serve as a governor 1 year. Mm. And then it is handed over to someone who is the first vice district governor. Okay. And people must show confidence. If they vote you, you go there. And you will be voted. And our voting is all the clubs must vote, not just a few. All the clubs in the district, like Uganda, we have 57. There must be a vote coming from every club. But I can serve in another capacity. Like now, Dr. Pio served in Kumi Central in another capacity as a director, but he is now graduating. I have appointed him. District officers and cabinet officers, it is the governor to appoint.
Hey.
It changes as you
You elevate. Okay. Yes. Dr. Pierre, if I can come to you now.
Yes,
is Lions Club religious?
Definitely not. We do not encourage any religious or political affiliation in the service of Lions. It's a voluntary service organization. Anybody with a heart to serve, maybe that's one benefit that we should emphasize the fact that sometimes you do something good, you feel good
yourself. Indeed, yeah, you, so you
maybe giving
service.
Maybe that is our religion. Yes.
The religion should be the service.
Service.
Yes.
Religion.
Yes.
Do
yes.
Not subscribe. To
because someone may say, maybe is this a religion of some sort? Is it some sort of cult?
No,
some sort of.
Not, there's nothing to do that. It's just service in our hearts.
Okay, mm-hmm. My brother.
Yes.
How do you guys make money? As Lions Club.
Yeah, thank you very much for that question.
Yes.
Basically, most of the members of the Lions Club have their jobs. When we come to Lions Club, we don't expect any payment. Like the governor has been saying, for us, we just come with a good heart and would wish, recognize that there's somebody, even if I'm not okay, but there is somebody who is less fortunate than I am. Then from the little resources that you have, we pull them together because, like, you know, he told you about Melvin Jones, the one who started the
way back, clubs.
Yes,
1917.
Way back,
yes.
He realized that there are so many people who actually do charity, but when you come together and you pull your little resources in an organized way, then it comes out very well. And basically, that's how we get our money. Of course, there are partnerships, like now we would wish. Like the new vision or Urban TV, we make a, like now we are, you've hosted us here.
Yes.
We are informing people, sensitizing people about Lions. That's a very good partnership. And we would wish also if there are other organizations, the governor encourages us to partner in wherever we have our clubs. Like for us, our club is in Luzira, Kampala Victoria Lions Club. We are making advance, we are in advanced stages of making some partnerships with National Water because the headquarters are there.
Oh, yes,
so
yes,
that
yes.
We partner with them so that whenever we are going for an activity, they come with us. In case it falls, the activity falls in their line of operation.
Yeah.
Like their theme this year is they are promoting environment, planting of trees, and the like. So when we went there for initial discussion, they told us, please write your proposal in this line. And basically, that's how we get our money. We don't join so that we get money, no.
But are you paid?
No, we are not paid completely. We are not paid. Like the governor, you see,
we
are not paid completely. We just serve with that good heart. Like you ask about the religion. The religion, like he said, is service. You have to have that religion in your heart that you want to serve.
So, governor, like any other organization, association, there are some of the challenges that come through. What have been some of the challenges that you have interfaced, like through your now like in your career, or should I say your governance? What are some been the challenges that have gotten through as a governor?
Some of the challenges when we are recruiting new members, one of the challenges is we cannot easily have those members who wish to become Lions automatically come. Because for you to become a member, you must subscribe. You must subscribe, you must give some dues so that you become a member. The other challenge we meet is this technology. We have to be connected.
True.
Some of our members are in remote areas, and sometimes we cannot reach to them easily. But like now, we have been told about other televisions also in Luo TV.
Yeah, we have one Luo. Yeah.
East.
One Luo, then we have East TV. Yeah.
Then Western.
Yes.
So we shall also try to link up our people.
Yes.
With the administrators of their clubs so that they are able to reach out. Then when we get disasters, oh, they think that the Lions must be able to serve them because they are a service organization. So you find that the expectations also of the community are so high. They want the Lions to serve them like government. But for
us... Oh, yes, yes, I get it, I hear you.
Uh-huh.
Because you come, they believe maybe you are under the government or you've been sent by the government, yes, yes.
So we have to explain to them that we supplement what government does.
Okay.
Like now, you know, there are floods affected the people Mbale. Of Bugisu,
yes.
Mbale. So we work with the foundation, Lions Club International Foundation. We apply for emergency grants because that is our money which is plowed back. And then when we are given $10,000, we buy items and then we take to them. And for us, the prestige of being a lion, you have to donate $1,000 to the foundation. And recently, yesterday, our chairman of Lions Club International Foundation left the country. He has been here visiting us. Raised money. We raised money, and this money goes to our foundation.
Okay.
And then it is shared world over.
Okay.
Look at Ukraine. Look at Uganda here. Look at Afghanistan. We are able to reach out. So this is a very committed and humble service organization with voluntarism. But we are not a bank. We are not we are not a government, but we are a service association, and we do it voluntarily. Even the children that doctor is talking about, childhood cancer, September is going to be a month of cancer. So
yeah, cancer
through
awareness, yes.
Urban TV, now the listeners will hear the message, and then we shall prepare our people to celebrate, to take their children to Mulago, to other health centers. So we find it something which is very good to do,
okay.
And we want to live above those challenges by sensitizing the less fortunate. And even the light people, they may not be knowing, but the club president of Victoria Luzira, we shall be there to sensitize people, to talk to them and give awareness.
Okay. Dr. Pio.
Yes, sir.
How did you hear about Lions Club? How did you get to know about it?
Well, it was way back in 1990 or thereabout. After I joined civil service, I was in Kumi. I heard about something called Lions. And as a matter of fact, like, if you were not there as a civil servant, maybe you're out of place. So it was another avenue to get together and socialize. But
yeah.
I also learned that they do service. And they have been in Lions since then.
What was your impression? Like, you go there first time. Was it, did you hear about through a friend? Through, because
yes.
He's talking about 1990, you must have been a young man.
Yes, I was
not,
young.
Yes.
I was young. And through friends. It was through friends. My initial, I thought, was just happiness, just go and have fun, good time. But as I joined, I learned that it is service. You have come.
So, what interested you to join? Because now, you know, someone introduces it to you. You are, you know, you're working, and you know, you think it's about partying or having fun. But then, hey, you say, oh, you know what? I think it's a good deal.
Yes. Around that time, there were many challenges in the communities that we come from. And one of the things I learned was that each one of us could contribute in one way or the other.
Yes.
And it need not necessarily be money. Actually, the strategy is that you put there, the way we do it, they call it three T's. Treasure. The money is the treasure. But also your talent. If you're a professional like me, there is something I can contribute other than necessarily having to put cash
exactly
to the service of the community.
Exactly.
And then the time. You take off your time, your treasure, and then your talent to serve the community. And this is really what interested me. There were so many, like, there was hunger around then. The floods have been on and off. The hospital where I work, there were definitely challenges of community illnesses. Many families unable to contribute, they are part of the bargain to achieve treatment. This is what pulled me into Lions.
And eventually we are here. Mommy Kasim.
Yes, please.
We tend to think and believe that to be a lion, I need to have a lot of money. I need to have a lot of property.
Mm-hmm.
I can't be in the Lions Club with that money.
Mm-hmm.
I gotta be rich.
Mm-hmm.
Is that the case?
No, completely no. Like the governor hinted, what is required is the heart to serve.
Mm.
Like we've told you, you just recognize that I'm not okay, but there's people who are less privileged.
Mm.
And then you have that heart to serve. It's not the money, it's just the little resources that all of us pull together, and then we do service the less privileged in an organized way. I would wish also to you to give a chance to the governor to highlight more on the benefits of Lionism and also the benefits that the country has achieved through Lionism, especially concerning the governor's visit. When you look at the projects, that for us annually there is some fee that we contribute, it goes to the international office. But when we get a problem here, even if we don't have a problem, you can just write a proposal to them. But when you look at the monies that they send us compared to what we contribute, it's quite a lot. And on a personal level, because you ask about the benefits, yes, in case somebody joined, we have so many trainings that the district organizes for us. When we talk about a district in Lionism, we meet the whole country. They organize for us a district. And when you find somebody who has been a lion, compared to some other person who is not a lion, the way you do your things, the way you program.
Yes.
And because there are trainings in leader, they emphasize so much trainings in leadership. The way you handle your things is very, but and also the like I told you last time when you asked me what are the benefits, I said, I mean, if I was not a lion, reaching this studio, how would I come? I would pay. But we come here and talk about things. Well, I have so many friends that I've interacted with, but we just passed through Lionism. Mm. Governor, you remember when you were in Mombasa for that convention?
Mm.
The proprietor of Toro Cement came around and he talked to us, and we exchanged numbers, and those ones who have been able to follow up, you find so many benefits.
Mm.
But even as a country, there are so many things that the country has benefited from Lionism. Okay. And I would wish the governor
to highlight. But before that, Madam Governor, how has Lions been relevant to today, if you look at today's world?
Lionism,
yes,
has been relevant because people have been emulating what we do.
Okay.
It is like you go out there, you stand, and you talk to the people to convince them, to tell them the usefulness of this service association.
Mm.
And because it comes from you as an individual,
yes,
you find that we have been able to touch the hearts of so many. Like we have our symbol, service from the heart.
Where service is from the heart.
Where is your heart?
Hmm?
Where is your heart?
You mean mine?
Yes.
My heart is in my body.
Yes.
It's in my.
So even we have this symbol here, service from the heart.
It is from the heart.
Yes. From the heart.
So you have to serve from your heart.
And it comes out, and you have to talk to the people.
Okay.
Without any attachment, but just sensitizing the people, training those who come out, and then you are able to achieve and draw them to your side. And then you say, we are not going to work alone as lions, but we are going to work as partners and network in service to our people. So as a district governor, I must promote citizenship maturity in this work that we do. Because we provide water to the people, we are able to go out and we are able to promote peace, even in those difficult areas. And we are able also to make it a point that we save mothers. Mothers and children through the activities of the Lions Clubs International Foundation. So, coming to Uganda here, we have done a lot.
You have?
Yes.
Okay.
Many projects. Let me start from TESO. TESO has got a diabetes project.
Problem, yes.
Awareness. They test people. They work with health centers. So there is a diabetes project. It's not little money.
It must be, of course.
It is United States dollars, $150,000.
What?
It's a lot of money, which is 500. It's because of the Lions that that money came here. Mm.
It's quite much money. Yeah.
When you go to northern Uganda, Pakwach, do you know where Pakwach is? Pakwach there in a sub-county of Pajobi. We, as Lions, in partnership with the Lions of Uganda, Lions Clubs International Foundation, has constructed two dormitories, one for the boys, one for the girls.
Yeah.
And we have utilized 74 million shillings for the construction of those dormitories.
Oh, that's a very good thing.
And it's then really construction of a community primary school in Kishase. You know, TESO, we don't have SH. Kishase.
Hmm?
My pronunciation. Can you pronounce that properly?
Kishase.
Kishase village in Rubaya sub-county in Kigezi.
Western Uganda.
Western Uganda. We are also catering for orphans and disabled children.
Yeah.
And when we look at those disabled children, we decided that a project should be there, and 370 million has been injected into that project. And the Ugandans provided a matching grant. And when the matching grant was provided, that project is up and running. We need to take you to Nsambia Hospital.
Right here.
Right here where we had taken the chairperson of Lions Club International Foundation. There is a very, very big very, very big eye
unit.
Care unit, which is being constructed. And it will be equipped by Lions Club International. And
The eye center?
Yes.
Oh.
And then they have finished first floor, second floor, and now they are awaiting for equipment. And we had to
all it is the works of Lions.
Work of Lions.
Okay.
That is a private institution. But also Mengo Hospital. You find that there is also that partnership. We test the eyes, eye testing.
Well, for free.
For free.
Okay.
And then they also give out glasses for people.
Okay.
I want also the viewers to know that there is a comprehensive eye care project in Kigezi region, southwestern Uganda, and they are providing eye health education, and the population in Kigezi region is also benefiting. We went to Bombo.
Yes, Bunyankuyege.
Bunyankuyege. We want to establish our service center there. And we want to serve over about 800,000 people in that part with the Lions Club. And it is supported by Lions Club of Kampala Central. Our LCIF, our Lions Club International Foundation coordinator is Lion Dr. Engineer Dance Naturinda, and we are working with him. So as we give our small
contributions,
as we sensitize members of our clubs, we are doing quite a lot. We don't want to work in isolation. We have to pattern with government. That's why when they distribute these kits for diabetes testing, we have to go to a health center 3. When you go to a health center 3, you get a clinician. Those health
people who will carry out the activity. Look at the floods, the hunger in Karamoja. Lions have been donating money. They have been donating money because when we heard that people in Karamoja are dying because of hunger, we could not lie backwards. Voluntarily, people through their clubs gave the money. And now we are going to buy relief. Then we go to government, Office of the Prime Minister. Give us
transport
so that we reach out to Karamoja. Give us the security so that we are
can
not
be able to, yeah, you can be able to move properly.
Yes, so we shall be able to go and give out relief to those people of Karamoja.
Okay.
So that is how good this association is. The other day we invited Her Excellency, the Vice President. We have also invited some ministers. We are going to induct them.
Hey.
So it gives me pleasure when I will induct
people
at that
policy making
level
yes.
to join us to serve, because their constituencies have needs. So
true.
We shall definitely
and in a way working them. Just briefly, Governor, I want to go to Dr. Opio here. Is there anything in, you know, in line of convention or meetup, big conferences, anytime now, or you don't have anything in terms of convention?
We have annual conventions.
That's once a year.
That's once a year.
Okay.
But there are quite a number of activities that are spread throughout the year. And the governor has a comprehensive program to cover the whole country.
Okay.
In the 1 year she's having her tenure. To visit the clubs, participate in some of the activities. And the activities like the one which is forthcoming for September. September is the Cancer Awareness Week. We are going to plan, we'll plan the activities at club levels, and especially with regard to my docket, what we normally do with such engagements under the umbrella of Lionism and in partnership with the with medical associations, we conduct camps, and those camps are intertwined with the conferences in which we sit, but also take time off to screen, attend to patients, and things of the like. Basically, that is what we have in store.
Okay. Monica-san,
yes,
can you let him choose him a little bit
yes,
for
sir.
You know, purposes of our people they are watching.
Yes, sir.
To what they need to get a little bit of change.
Yes, sir.
Ninabagana bange, but you know, bali muchiembe, abasubuzi, bali muchukubo, you know.
Yes, sir.
Maybe they would be interested. Now, ngana wulida, if you be in Angabino, bali agado be a gatako. Nemulinga babi chusa, nebifuka weaba, munemu abayivu. I've seen Dr. Pio, you know, the governor here, yourself as well. Ndabanga, there's some sort of a disconnect. Kumuntu awansi obuli yao. Ati mulenga wewunyi, aina mune kasendi. Nenga tayina bwatuka. So, Lions ya baluzungu. Ya bayivu, actually.
Neyanze sebo, yes sebo. Webali nyechi wuzeche, wela webali lidala. Lions ya baluzungu. Era nga bw'ogambye Lions y'abantu bonna abalina omutima. Era bw'otunulamu ne ssente zetuwa buli mwaka, kubanga buli mwaka tulina omutima gwe tuwa. Naye ng'olabira ddala ng'omuntu azisobola. Ate organization oba district governor's office etugaidinga nnyo n'etugamba nti bwe kiba kisoboka nga tusobola kuziwa zonna ozisupuredinga mu mwaka gwonna. Clubs esinga obunyizibwa 300-350. Naye ng'osobola ozaawulamu okumala omwaka mulamba. Ekitegeeza nti buli mwezi osobola okusasula 500-300. Ekitegeeza nti omuntu yenna n'oyo gw'oyita owa wansi asobola okukola ki? Ate nga bwe kugambye ebintu bya Lionism being engaged kuwamu okusanyuka muri satisfactioning go because oyambi omuntu to lose to kola cataract surgeries. Cataract surgeries inti waliwo akabubi akajja ku maaso gano. Omuntu naloza anti azibya amaaso. Na yenga tulina program ya amanyi nye ya maaso bagena ne tukola camps ne balongosa abantu bwerere omuntu ne yesanga nga alaba. Na yeka tugwa chikoze ngo omuntu wa wansi bo chikola no laba omuntu nga baletalaba kumala emyaka na alaba chikusanyusa nnyo. So kudda mwe kibuzo kyo Lions Club si abantu bagagga a bantu ba wansi bantu ba bulijjo
si abantu bayivu
si abantu bayivu
strictly ndi a
Chichecho, tewali era ne mu club si za fizo na tebawa na gundi nti mulina kubera mulula mu olzo waliwo chewega nti official language yoko isango communicating especially nga mulimu mu conversion izi ruzungu na yenga musobola okukola ibintu byamwe mu lulimi lwa mwerona ne mukyusa disgovernance jukira ne gundi yachogedde na gamba waliwo ensi Asian countries. I remember this, the international president yagambye tebawayo sene naye ne basaba ennimi zino ebintu ebikwatagana ne lionism babizze mu nnimi zaabwe era ne
bakkiriza
osobola okubitegera mu nyikati
yesoloji ngamba nti obaoliawo abantu klasse emu ebadde abandon the awareness is safe. I think the governor will explain this more. Don't you think it has been left to those we believe they can afford? Yet I have a strong feeling that even when we get down to these other sectors, you know, the other who actually are not level, you know, your level, they're actually interested. Is there that awareness? Has it been that aggressive? Has it been there to that other person to actually be able to understand about Lions and maybe even join?
Yes, the international president has established a new office, extension,
okay,
district extension officer, which means you have to reach to all the clubs and don't only remain at these board members, but reach out to the person down there. When you go to Bukoto Kamocha,
yes,
we are reaching out to that down woman there selling charcoal, selling tomatoes, because we have now started a circle. We Lions started a circle for a few women. When we gave them 9 million, they are now growing, and we are using extension now to reach out so that it simmers down to the people.
That bit I understand and agree.
Even
but the recruitment of people who are middle class earners, people who are like downtown,
yes,
and they cannot affiliate, probably even express themselves in English, you understand what I'm saying, but they would want to be part of this organization, but they seem to be not connected. That gap, you, I don't know whether you get my point.
I get your point.
Not the beneficiaries, for that matter, but a guy like, I don't want to use names here, but people who are doing businesses downtown, and they would want to be part of Lions Club, but they feel they don't even know how to get there. Or even furthermore, they feel it is for elites.
We want to demystify that.
Exactly.
Where people keep saying that Lions is for the rich.
Elite and rich.
Elite and rich.
Yes.
No?
So then how are we going to do this?
We are going to have the approach of sensitization and awareness. We need to train people who will take the message down to the grassroots to bring those people to the level of getting to know that this association, which is now 104 years old, was not just started and left hanging. That is why now we want to reach down to that person who is a beneficiary. And we have started doing that. When we went to Bulyakuyenge yesterday, we had to get the LOC1.
Oh, at that level?
At that level.
Yes.
That LOC1, you in your council, don't come here and be a spectator. We want you to be a participant together with the members of your community,
And when we reached there, the women were saying, how do we participate?
Mm.
Which answers your question? Mm. And we had now to tell them how they are going to participate, how they are going to be part and parcel of the Lions Club Association. We have been seeing that as a challenge, and it is good you have asked us. That's where we are putting now emphasis, the beneficiary down there. The challenge, of course, is our people are poor. They may not be able to afford our registration fee, the dues that we pay.
The yearly fees.
But we have to find a mechanism as a district and also as a Lions Foundation, how best we can handle the aspect of bringing those people closer to the association and see how they can participate. Because the younger ones who are out of school, but they are having some skills to do, we want to make them part and parcel of this whole association. So it is one area that I am taking note of as a district governor.
I'm curious to know about that, and Michael will be interested as well. Maybe you never, yeah, because we need to get down and sensitize more.
And when I
come, and even recruit more.
Yes, when I come back here, I should be able to explain to you a full strategy of how we are handling those other categories of people who are down there. They want to belong from Luzira, from Kabalagala, from I come with a formidable action plan for them. Yes. That is very, very important. Even the youth, there are very many out there.
Yes. You need to amalgamate the two, because you're getting from the youth, they're getting where you are. Even I'm looking at even how do you, can you get even more young ladies be part of this? How do you put them together? By the way, my time is up, and I would want to have, first of all, Dr. Pio, your last remark as far as Lions is concerned. And then I will definitely get to Mr. Kisami there, and of course the governor, summarize.
Okay. Thank you. Like I would like to say, there has been no shortage of community members asking how they join Lionism. And quite often we've rushed to recruit them, and thereby challenges come in as far as making their commitments come through. But the strategy is that we take you through a period of courtship. You can be around, you can hang around the club like 1 year, attend our meetings, attend our activities, and see how things move. Eventually, be able to make an informed decision. I would like to talk about really my area of specialty, like something that is forthcoming about childhood cancer awareness. It is a responsibility and duty of every citizen to be on the lookout, to have a high index of suspicion for what might turn out to be a cancer ailment, especially in children, because children, they have a long life ahead of them. Not to say that adulthood cancers are not important, but the children have a long life ahead of them. And most importantly, their cancers are treatable. The earlier we get them, the better.
They're much better, yes.
The better. And of course, we would like to reach out to stakeholders. The challenges of cancer diagnosis, referral and treatment especially are daunting. The costs are quite high.
Nkwebaza
nnyo nebaza nnyo Urban TV ate ne nebaza n'abantu bonna abatulabye eri abantu bange kye mmanyi eyo mu Upper Prison bali wano bali
tunebaza
baseeyi abange mwebale nnyo era tubatumidde mayizi abatumidde n'abantu bange ababaka Kingsley Nikita ne bonna mwebale kutulaba era neighbors, I would like to thank the district governor for honoring our invitation and coming to highlight on the issues concerning Lionism, Dr. Pio, concerning cancer, and thank you, Urban TV, for the sensitization. Thank you.
Madam Governor, I just have a minute.
Thank you so much.
Let's use it, yes.
Our target is to serve 1 million people this Lionistic year. And we also expect to recruit many more partners, many more to work with us. I have the honor and pleasure to tell you that out of the 1,857 members we serve, we need to get more clubs.
Indeed.
And I want to give this summary to you for record
your
office.
Yeah, thank
we
you
want
very much.
To thank you so much for hosting us.
Okay.
And we hope to come again.
No problem.
And this is our handbook.
Okay.
I need to hand it to you.
Oh, thank you very much. I appreciate
it. And we do service with the friendship. I have to stand up when I'm giving it to you.
We will be out of position of the camera if you... <We'll definitely laughs> he needs to raise it a bit.
I have to give you this book.
Okay.
Because this is what we follow.
Okay.
As we work. I also would like to hand you with a pen so that when you are writing, you read.
Okay.
That this is a lion's pen.
Oh, thank you very much.
So that when I come again,
okay,
I would
have a pen and I have a book.
You will have a pen.
Thank you very much. So this is the service now.
That is the service.
Thank you so much, guys. Of course, we're going to go. We know you're out of time, but we would like to appreciate, of course, our friends here coming through. We'll definitely have them next time. Please go join Lions Club at your level. I mean, it has nothing to do with being rich. I don't know, English. Thanks so much, of course. Good to see you guys. Hope to see you again.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.
Have a great day.
You too.
And bye-bye.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.